Good morning. We are going to determine the average power delivered by a car engine in this example.
Flippin' physics.
Billy, could you please read the problem? And Bo, could you please translate?
A 1,400 kilogram Prius uniformly accelerates from rest to 3.0 times 10 to the first kilometers per hour in 9.25 seconds and 42 meters.
Stop. Mass equals 1,400 kilograms. Initial velocity is zero. Final velocity is 3.0 times 10 to the first kilometers per hour. Displacement is 42 meters, and change in time is 9.25 seconds.
We need the velocity in the velocity final in meters per second. So let's convert that now. Multiply 30. Kilometers per hour by 1 hour over 3,600 seconds and multiply by 1,000 meters over 1 kilometer to get 8.3 repeating meters per second.
Thank you, Billy. Could you please read the rest of the problem?
If an average force of drag of 8.0 newtons acts on the car, what is the average power developed by the engine in horsepower?
Drag force is 8.0 newtons, and the average power delivered by the engine equals question mark.
A drag force of 8 newtons seems really small. Is that really correct?
Actually, yes. I have an entire video which describes exactly how I determined that average force of drag. The main reason it is so small is because of the car's low speed. The maximum speed of the car is 30 kilometers per hour, which is roughly 19 miles per hour.
Sure, the car is moving slowly, so the force of drag is small. Okay.
Bobby, what are the two equations for power, and which can we use in this problem?
Power equals work divided by change in time. And power also equals force times velocity times cosine theta. If we were solving for instantaneous power, we would need to use power equals force times velocity times cosine theta. However, because we are solving for average power, we can use either equation.
Correct. When solving for average power, you can use either of the two equations. And when solving for instantaneous power, you have to use the second of the two equations. And you have to use instantaneous velocity. Let's use the first of the two equations and substitute in the equation for work. Work equals force times displacement times the cosine of the angle between those two vectors. Billy, what force does the engine deliver to the car?
Well, can we call it a force applied by the engine on the car?
Sure. We are solving for the average power delivered by the force applied to the car. Notice how we already know the change in time and the displacement, but we need to find the force applied and the angle theta between the direction of the force applied and the direction of the displacement. Bo, what should we do next?
Let's draw the free body diagram.
Absolutely right, Bo. Why don't you do so, please?
The force of gravity is down, the force normal is up, the drag force is to the left, and the force applied is to the right. And we can sum the forces in the y direction. The net force in the y direction equals force normal minus force of gravity, which equals mass times acceleration in the y direction. The car isn't moving in the y direction, so the acceleration in the y direction is zero. So the force normal equals the force of gravity, which equals mass times acceleration due to gravity.
Bo, please keep going.
The net force in the x direction equals force applied minus the drag force, which again equals mass times acceleration, only this time in the x direction. We don't know the acceleration in the x direction. However, we can still solve for the force applied and put the equation in our equation holster.
Equation holster!
Add drag force to both sides, and the force applied equals mass times acceleration in the x direction plus the drag force.
Bobby, we need the acceleration. How are we going to find it?
The equation for acceleration is acceleration equals change in velocity over change in time. So final velocity minus initial velocity divided by change in time, or 8.3 repeating minus 0 divided by 9.25, which is 0.9009 meters per second squared, which we can plug back into the Holstered equation. So force applied equals 1400 times 0.9009 plus 8, which is 1,269.26 newtons.
Billy, what about theta? What is the angle in this problem?
The force applied is to the right, and the displacement of the car is to the right, and the angle between to the right and to the right is 0 degrees, so theta is 0 degrees.
Bo, could you please finish the problem?
We can substitute back into the equation we have for power. Power equals 1,269.26 times 42 times cosine of 0 degrees, all divided by 9.25, which is 5,763.13 watts.
And remember, I asked you to convert the answer to horsepower.
I don't remember how many watts are in a horse.
It's in your notes. 746 watts equals 1 horsepower.
Multiply by 1 horsepower over 746 watts to get 7.7256, or 7.7 horsepower with 2 significant figures. Thanks, Billy.
You are welcome.
7.7 horsepower. This is essentially like taking roughly 8 average horses, strapping them to the front of your vehicle, and yelling, "Yah!" Right?
Kinda? Sure.
That seems pretty weak.
Okay, let's take a closer look at the example problem. The car goes from 0 to 30 kilometers per hour, or 19 miles per hour, in roughly 9 seconds.
Wow, that sure ain't fast.
Yes, Bo, however, this is how I prefer to drive my car, and I will tell you, in order to drive like this, you do not have to put your foot very far down on the accelerator pedal, or what I prefer to call the horse pedal.
The what? Wow. What kind of pedal was what? That?
The horse pedal. Listen carefully. The farther you put your foot down on the horse pedal, the more horsepower of your engine you are choosing to use. And therefore, the more horses you are metaphorically strapping to the front of your vehicle. And I don't know if you knew this, but horses eat hay, and hay costs money. Which means the farther you put your foot down on the horse pedal, the more hay you will have to buy. And after horses eat hay, they digest the hay, and then they expel horse poop. Which means, the farther you put your foot down on the horse pedal, the more horses you will have to metaphorically strap to the front of your vehicle, and the more hay you will have to buy, and the more horse poop we will all have on the road. And that horse poop doesn't just stay on the road, it actually spreads all over the planet. Are you following my analogy?
I totally get it.
Unfortunately,
yeah.
Yes. Good. So please, be gentle with the horse pedal. Let's save some money and have less horse poop on the planet. Thank you very much for...
We didn't need to sum the forces in the Y direction, did we?
Nope. We did not need the force normal. So, in this problem, we did not need to sum the forces in the Y direction.
Man. I hate it when we do extra work for nothing.
You know what? Let's quantify my horse poop analogy. In the original example, I pressed very gently on the accelerator pedal, and it took 9.25 seconds to travel 42 meters. If instead I slam the accelerator pedal all the way down, it only takes 5.43 seconds for the car to travel the same distance. The original final velocity was 30 kilometers per hour, 19 miles per hour, or 8.3 meters per second. The new final velocity is 56 kilometers per hour, 35 miles per hour, or 16 meters per second. The original average force of drag acting on the car was 8.0 newtons. Now it is 26 newtons. The original acceleration was roughly 0.9 meters per second squared, and the larger acceleration is about 2.9 meters per second squared. Now, I know I am moving through this pretty quickly, however, it mostly repeats the problem just with different numbers. So if you want to see the equations in more detail, please use the link which just appeared to access my lecture notes. The original force applied was about 1,270 newtons, and the new force applied is about 4,040 newtons. The work done on the car by the engine in the original example is roughly 53,000 joules. The work causing the larger acceleration is roughly 170,000 joules. In other words, in order to decrease the time of the event by 41%, you need to use 220% more joules of energy. That is a lot of unnecessary horses, hay, and poop on the planet. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you. By the way, I do understand horses also eat grass and oats. However, it was just easier to say hay. Also, if you found my repeated use of the word poop in this video offensive, I do apologize. However, I think it was totally worth it.